Last one, topic is algebra. As we said in the previous lesson, algebra, what should come into your mind is unknown or variable. So, unknown is used to represent a certain information. And then you have said you must be keen on the signs. If you're not keen on signs, then you find that you will not tackle algebraic expression and algebraic equations correctly. So we have said in the previous lesson that we have two types of algebra. We have algebraic equation and algebraic expression. You have given examples of expression like 2x, 4x plus 8. So these are two terms that are joined by addition. They are representing a certain information. We say examples of equation is like 4x plus 8 is equals to maybe 21, that this expression, we are balancing this expression with a value on the other side. Hence, from the word equation, there is the word equal. And this is the one that is balancing both sides. So today, we want to form algebraic equation and expression. Notice, if we may start with simple ones. For example, John is 2 years older than James. John is 2 years older than James. So the first thing is to identify the personalities. When I'm talking about the personalities, I'm referring to these groups here that we want to compare. So in our groups here, we are talking about people. So when you are grouping, then you must identify the personalities. We have John and James. So in our case, when you are forming algebraic expression, the simplest way it is to use the last person. You represent, you use unknown to fill in the information of the last person mentioned. In our case, in our statement, the last person here is James. So if we may decide to use X to represent the age of James, then in our table here, we are going to write X years. So if James is X years, then we can now read the statement starting from John. And no, because whenever we are talking about John, we are referring to James. So the first thing is we take the age of James here, and then we compare. What are we told in the statement? John is 2 years older than James. So the age of James, we add 2 years. So that this is an expression of representing the age of John, and X was the one that we decided to represent the age of James. So if we take an alternative of this, it's not a must that you write X under James. You can also write X under John. For example, if I write X here, therefore I must rephrase this statement. I must start with James. Because you have said John is 2 years older than James, then we can start with James. Because we want to know the expression that is representing the age of James. So we can start by saying, if John is 2 years older than James, then we can say James is 2 years younger. This one responds to the first person mentioned. So James is 2 years younger than John. And because you are referring to the age of John, under James, you first write the age of John. So you write X. Then from there, what are you told? That James is the one who is 2 years younger. So it will be minus 2. Note that. I have said that you must know how to rephrase the statement. Another example, John is twice as old as James. Let's look at this statement. So the first thing we have said, identify the personalities. We have John and James. You have said the last person will take unknown. So in our case, I'm using X. So let my X represent the age of James. Now, because I want to fill under John, the one who is making, the one who is making us get the age of John is James. So the word that you have written here is the one that you should start with. Then from there, read the statement. John is twice as old. Twice means times two. So it is the age of James times two, which is 2x. Alternatively, you can represent this way. In the first one, you have used x under James. You can also use x under John. But now, when you are filling the information under James, you must rephrase the statement. The statement is, James is 2 years, sorry, John is twice as old as James. So if you start with James, it will be James is, because you are told John is that who is twice, so James is a half. Or James is a half as old as John. Not this, the opposite of twice. Twice is representing, is referring to James. So the opposite of that would be half. Now, because James is the one who is half the age of John, the reference point is John. So our x is that you are going to start with, and then you are told half. So times a half. So the age of James is a half x. So let's look at some examples. Hope you have understood those two statements. So the first one is Akini is has y bananas. This is 3 times as many bananas as Wedera has. They have 36 bananas altogether. And now the question is form the equation. So the first thing, identify the personalities. We have Akini and Wedera. Now in this question, we are told we must use y to represent the number of bananas Akini had by that time. So y represents the number of bananas. Then from there, you are told this. Whenever the word is used, it's referring to whatever was there. So it means that these are the number of bananas Akini had. So it is like saying Akini had 3 times as many as Wedera. Akini had 3 times as many as Wedera. And now because we are answering under Wedera, so we can rephrase the statement starting with Wedera. So you say Wedera has a dad, because Akini is the one who has what? 3 times. So Wedera has a dad. So it is a dad of what Akini had by that time. So this one will be a dad y. Of means multiplication. Then from there, you are told the two had 36. So total here, total number of bananas is 36. Then you are told to form the equation. This, you must join these two, because we are asked the total number of bananas. How do we join this one? By adding the two, because we are asked all together. So it will be y plus a third y is equal to 36. So that is how we form the equation. You can continue by working. Not here, you are told to write the equation. So you should not go beyond this. Maybe the only point you should go beyond this is when you want to move the denominators. Or you can also add these two. But when you are told to form the equation, you can leave your answer up to that point. So you can add these two to get one and a third y is equal to 36. But this one is not recommended because you are told to write an equation. Then from there, or you can remove the denominators, as we say, multiply all terms by the LCM. Our LCM is 3. So here you'll be left with 3 times y, 3y plus by 3 1, you'll be left with y is equal to 36, you multiply by 3. This is 18, 8 can 1. This is 9, 10. It's equal to 108. So you have any of the two. That is y plus a third y is equal to 36. Or 3y plus y is equal to 108. The two are correct. Note, it is not good to add these two, because you are only told to write the equation. The next question. You are told to find size of angle A, B, C. B is at the middle. So it means you are told to find this angle. If you take an example, the normal ones that we are used to, if you take this one to be 60 and 70, and you are told to find this angle, we know that interior angles in a triangle add up to 180. So here you must form the equation. You must form the equation. That is, if you may call this one A, it will be A plus 60 plus 70 is equals to 180. And then you add these two, which is A plus 1, that is equals to 180. Take plus to the side to be minus 130. So your A will be 50 degrees. The way you do the working here is what we are supposed to do under algebra. Because you are going to find this angle, then what have we done here? We have added the known angles. We have subtracted from the total number of degrees, which is 180. The same applies to this. If you want to get this angle, it is 180. We subtract the sum of the known angles, which is x plus y. And this is the answer that represents angle ABC. Note, you cannot write 180 minus x plus y. Why? Because when you fail to put brackets, it means this negative only represents y, but it is not representing 10. I mean, it's only represents x, but it's not, does not represent y. So this is wrong. This is wrong. So our next question. Okay, alternative of this, before you go to the next question, you can open the bracket. So you can also write it as 180 minus x. When you open the bracket and you have a negative sign, the sign in the bracket changes, so it will be minus y, not plus y. So these two will be the answer. So here you are told to find the perimeter, and you are told to use L as our unknown. So you know that this is curve, and the formula is a half IB. Then perimeter, you must move around until you come back to the same point. So our M is representing the diameter. So I know that perimeter is equal to a half IB, the curve, then you go through our diameter. Remember, we are told to use M. Our M is the diameter. So where there is B, we must replace by that M. So our perimeter will be a half, pi, we know it is 22 over 7 times M plus M. Then you can simplify this by 2, 1 by 2, 11. So you have 11 over 7 M, that is 11 times M, 11 M over 7 plus M. So you can also, you can add this, you can write over 1. This one means whenever you have written M over 1 is like 1 over 1. So it's like 11 over 7 plus 1 over 1. LCM is 7. Divide here to get 11 plus 7, which is 18 over 7. So this is the same as how many 7s are here? There are 2 because of 14, it means 4 over 7. So this one can be represented as 247M. Remember, you are going to use M. Our last question. The number of women passengers in a bus was P. The number of children in the bus was 3 times that of men, but 6 more that of women. If they were 28 passengers, write an equation to represent the information. Number 1, identify the personalities. We have women, we have men, and children. From there, we are given an instruction that we must use P to represent women. So you come here and write P under women. Take a statement that is connecting women and any of the two groups. And which is the statement? You are told the number of women was P. The number of children in the bus was 3 times that of men. We don't know the number of men. So we must continue with our statement, where you are told but 6 more that of women. So it means the number of children is the one that is 6 more that of women. So you take the reference point, which is P, and then you are also told there are 6 more, we have 6. Then you go back to the question. The number of children in the bus was 3 times. The number of children was 3 times that of men. So because under men, our reference point is children, so we must take the number of children. Remember, children are the ones that are 3 times,
times. So men will be at that. So it's like we are dividing by 3. So this is right. P divided by 3 is a third P. 6 divided by 3 is 2. And then the question is, we write the equation where our total, is 28. So this one will be P plus a third P plus 2 plus P plus 6 is equals to 28. P plus P, that is 2, plus a third, that is 2, and a third P plus 2 plus 6 is 8 is equals to 28. So that is our final answer. And we have said you can also remove the denominators where you must write this one as improper. This is 6 plus 1, 7 over 3, P plus 8 is equals to 28. You remove the denominator, that is you multiply all terms by 3. So this is 7P plus 24 is equals to 28, you multiply by 3. This is 4 carry 2, this is 6, add to 8 is equals to 84. So the answer is 2 and a third P plus 8 is equals to 28, or 7P plus 24 is equals to 84. Any of the answer is okay. So hope you have enjoyed the lesson. Thank you.